The country of Peru is one of the most interesting and naturally beautiful throughout the world. With 60% of the country covered by the Amazon rainforest, as well as having world-renowned sites like the Machu Picchu or the Rainbow Mountains. However, the country's football isn't on the same level of notoriety as its natural beauty. The two-time Copa America champions haven't won the competition since 1975, and I don't think many people would fault you if you were to say you had no idea as to what happens with football in Peru. But that doesn't make it any less interesting as to what's going on in the top flight of the South American country. But today we are going to look at a match so bizarre that happened in the Peruvian League final in 2023 between the country's two most heated rivals, Universitario versus Alianza Lima. But before we look into this match, I want to give you a quick history lesson on the two sides, their importance to Peruvian football, and why they are heated rivals. First, let's start off with Universitario. Founded in 1924 by students and professors at one of Peru's best schools, 5 years after founding, they would head into the first division and win their first title in 1929. The club, who is going to celebrate its 100th birthday this year, has won the most Peruvian Liga 1 titles with 27. They are also the first club in Peru to make it to the Copa Libertadores final in 1972. But unfortunately, they lost that match to the Argentine squad Independiente. But it is still one of their greatest achievements, as no other Peruvian team has actually won the tournament. As for their cross-city rivals in the Peruvian capital, Alianza is another Peruvian giant. Founded in 1901, they were basically the first big club in Peru, and are also considered the most popular. It is actually the only surviving member of the original Peruvian League, and they have the second most titles, with 25, just trailing two behind their biggest rivals. When these two clubs play, it is called the National Derby, and it is easily the biggest game of the season when they meet, and it could even be violent at times. These two would meet in the playoffs, and you may be asking yourself, well, isn't this a league? Why are there playoffs? Well, let me explain. In Peru, the league table works differently than the traditional European leagues, with the league split into two different parts, the Apertura and Clausura. With the first 18 games going toward the Apertura league table, whoever places first in the standings will be put into the playoff, and then everyone's point tallies get reset back to zero for the Clausura, where another 18 games are played. Then the winner of the Clausura will be put in a two-leg playoff final against the winner of the Apertura, which decides the champion of Peru for that year. Hopefully I put that in a way where everybody could understand, but anyways, the 2023 Liga 1 campaign saw Alianza win the Apertura and rivals Universitario would win the Clausura, pitting these two in the biggest match of Peru's season. And the stakes were high, because Alianza was fighting for their third title in a row, winning the last two, and the first match would be at their rival stadium. With many eager to see the matchup, the former champions looked really disappointing, letting up 59% possession and 20 shots against their net, while Alianza only had two. But the game was filled with great chances, and a disallowed goal for Universitario. However, they were able to get a penalty in the 63rd minute, which they converted. However, Alianza would get the last laugh, as in the 94th minute, Costa would receive the ball in the box, and with the last kick of the game would silence the crowd. 1-1 would be the final result, putting the second leg as the title decider. Alianza had all the momentum going into it, as the match would be played in their stadium. It would all come down to this. And Universitario had a great start, scoring in the 3rd minute. After that, the match would go back and forth, with this time Alianza having the possession. But the dagger would come in the 82nd minute for Universitario, when an out-of-the-box screamer would give them the 2-0 lead. But hold on, because this is where things just get crazy. See, Universitario was able to hold on to their lead, and the second the final whistle blew, players were ready to run onto the pitch and celebrate their championship, the first one in a 10-year drought, only for Alianza to deliberately cut off the lights in the stadium. Yes, you heard that right. The stadium would go pitch black, except for the billboards around the pitch. And honestly, I have never seen something like this before. I would actually think that this would be dangerous because of the low visibility in such a crowded area. But luckily, no one was harmed. And due to this, Universitario were unable to lift their trophy and celebrate at the stadium. After this, Universitario's board would make a statement calling out their rivals, saying it was shameful and that they should face consequences for their actions. However, Alianza would say that they were just trying to protect their fans as well as everyone else in the stadium, making sure everyone left the stadium as quickly as possible. They also noted that all exits and corridors were properly lighted and they only turned off the main floodlights. But I don't know how I feel about that explanation. What do you guys think? I was trying to find out if Alianza actually got punished for this act, but I think they got off with a slap on the wrist, as I can't find any real information as to what happened. What we do know is that these two-bitter rivals will keep chasing glory in the Peruvian League, but this match in particular was just wild. Make sure to like this video and subscribe.